In this vlog, we will try to see how to design a simple website in Flutter. So now we have added an asset. So we have added a logo that needs to be displayed in our website here, and specify the same in pubspec file here. So under the assets, I have specified the logo, and now let's start with our coding. So let's import material dot dart file, void main. So inside I'm considering our default class my app, and now let us declare the class my app. So yes, now let's try to return a material app. Inside the home, we will be declaring a scaffold. So this particular scaffold will provide the structure for our project. And here you can see these are all the properties which we can make use of using a scaffold here. So as we are designing website, we are not making use of the app bar which we use for our mobile application. So directly we are going to declare the body over here. And inside the body, I'm just considering a stack. With the help of a stack widget, we can easily arrange our components inside our website one over the another. We have seen rows and columns previously, so this is a kind of a widget where we can align our layouts. For example, we want to display a text on my particular image. So in this particular scenario, we can make use of a stack and make it possible. So in this website, let us try to use the stack layout here and see how it's gonna look in. And inside the stack, we need to declare the children here, and there I just want to have a single child scroll view here. As we are dealing with a website, scroll view is a basic component here. So compared to our mobile application, web page will have more data, so we need to have a scroll view to handle this particular data. So now inside the scroll view, we are going to take a container, and this particular container we will be having some margin. So symmetric I am considering here, so symmetric and with a margin of 32 over here. So inside this container we will be further having some child here, and it will be contain a column, so that we will be adding multiple widgets. So inside the column, the first children we contain is again a container. This particular container will have a margin of symmetric again, and this time we will be having 32 on vertical. So inside this container we will be having one more child, and this time it will be having row here. So inside the row, add the children, and here you need to specify the widget gesture detector, and inside which specify the on tap. Currently we are not making any process when you tap on this particular widget here. And also I am trying to add a child tag here, and inside which I am going to specify an image that is coming from asset. And in the starting of the tutorial we have added an image, right? So I'm going to specify that particular image now. So assets.logo.png, make sure you provide the name completely and with the specified format of the image. We need to have one more child inside this particular row, and that is flexible. Why we have made use of gesture detector and flexible here? With the help of a gesture detector, we are trying to show a logo onto our website. Just like in our homepage, we will be showing our website logo, and when the user taps on that particular logo, we will be redirecting to our homepage. So on whatever the page the user may be, like profile, about, or whatever the page it may be, we will be redirecting back to our home page, right? So it's a basic functionality. So for making sure that functionality is available in our Flutter website, we are adding a gesture detector, and also we have added a flexible here to make sure we display the menu on our website. So inside the flexible, I'm going to consider a container, and inside which I'm going to declare a child wrap. So with the help of a wrap, we can easily place our menu items one after the another by providing the sufficient space in between them. So inside the wrap, we need to provide a list of widgets we need to be displayed. So here I am going to specify a text button, and here I am going to leave the onPress functionality for now. And inside the child, I am going to specify a text widget which will be showing home. And in the same way, I'm going to add few more pages to our website here. So home, about, profile, contact, help. And like this, you can add as many pages as you want here. So with the help of the flexible, it will be easier for us to place the menu items on our website. Inside the flexible, you are having an option to provide the flex property here. So here, if you specify it based upon the weights you provide, the widgets will be arranged in the proper constraints. In the Android programming, we are having a concept called weights. So with the help of the weights, we can provide the space covered by that particular widget onto the screen. So the same way, using the flex, we can provide the weights to our particular widgets in Flutter programming too. So here we are having only one flexible property here. So we will be dealing with the flexible in our further coming tutorials, and I will be showing you with a real-time example. Till now, let us try to run the particular code and see what is the output. Here you go, this is our output for the website which we have designed currently, and now the image size is too big, and let us try to limit its size here. So these are all the properties available, and inside I'm going to specify width here. So whenever you are having any doubts regarding the available properties inside the widget, you can just tap on this particular widget with the help of the command button in Mac and control button in Windows. So here I want to specify the width to be 50. So here now let us try to save. So home, about, profile, contact us, help, and now we want to have them to the right hand side. So inside our container, make use of the alignment property and specify alignment dot center of right here. So now let us try to see the output once. So you can still see the code is running on back, performing hot restart. So yes, our menu items are to the right hand side now. And also let us remove the debug banner, specify it to be false. Yes, we are not able to see the debug banner now. And here we will be trying to add some data to our website. So now let's try to close this particular container. I want to display an image with the help of a network here. So I want to load an image from a URL. So I am trying to add an image from Unsplash here. So this is the particular image I want to load to our website. Try to save the code, and here you can see our image is now loaded. And also you can add the image to your local assets folder here, and you need to specify the same in a pub spec here. So but I just want to add it from the network because we have added an image from local folder already. So I just want to show you from network now. We need to add a footer to our website also. So it might be a mobile application or a website. Header and footer are the important aspects of a page here. So in the same way, we are going to add a container, and inside the container, so here we will be adding a text widget, and inside which I am going to specify a website name. You can just add your own customizations here, and I want to wrap it with a widget align, and which will align my text to the center, bottom center. I will be specifying it. So now try to refresh our web page and check the output. So here you can see we have got our name printed just after the image, and now we want to have some space in between the image and our footer. So try to provide a margin, some margin here, and this time I want to have vertical of 50 here. Try to see the output. Yeah, it looks much better now. So this is how we create a basic website in our Flutter, and in our further coming tutorials we will try to customize this website with Google fonts, and also we will be styling our footer and header. And finally, to add web support to your project, you need to run a command flutter create, and you can notice in our code that we don't have a web directory. After adding the web support, you will be able to see the web directory in your code. And now to release the build for web, you need to run this particular command flutter build web. So here you can see the status compiling main.dart for the web, and here you can see our web directory is being created now, and also you can see other folders like Mac OS, Linux and Windows 2. Inside the web directory you can see the things like favicon. So in our further coming tutorials we will be trying to replace this particular favicon so that in the output you can have your own logo. And in our further coming tutorials we will be also going through these particular files, index.html, manifest and more. So yes, this is it for this tutorial. In this blog we will continue updating our website which we have created. Here you can see the output. So this is a website where we have provided a sample menu, a image in the center of the screen and also a footer here. So now let us try to make some styling as we have discussed in our previous tutorial. So for which I am adding a plugin Google Fonts, and currently I am not specifying any version, but you may specify it according to the latest available so as to avoid any issues regarding the code. So now we have added our dependency Google Fonts. Now let us try to apply them to our code here. So here inside our text, let us make the styling by specifying the style tag here. We can directly make use of the Google Fonts, the plugin which we have just added. So let us make it into a new line, and here now you can select any font from the available list of the fonts here. So these are all the list of the fonts. So if you have observed our previous tutorials, we have dealt with specifying fonts manually by adding them to our folders in our project and specifying them in our project, and also we have seen how to deal with the Google fonts. I will be providing the link in the description section below how to apply the Google fonts to your project, so you may also go through it. But for this part of the tutorial I am going to use this particular font, and here inside which everything is normal. As you can see, we can just specify the font size here. I am specifying 18 for now, and also color you can specify. I want to have a light blue or blue color is also. What are all the additional features we can specify is like font weight, we can specify font weight to be bold. Okay, now let us try to arrange them, and now try to update our code and have a look at it. So yes, you can clearly observe some change, and also you can choose your own font depending upon your requirement here. So out of Google Fonts there are more number of options. So now let us try to apply the same styling for all the remaining text buttons too. But here I want to make it much more simple here. So we have completely designed a button home, and we are still having about profile, contact us and help. So we need to write the same code 4 more times. So we will make the use of the code reusability options available in Flutter here. So go to the Flutter outline here. If there is nothing visible in the Flutter outline, you just tap on this widget, and here you can see the hierarchy of our widgets is being displayed in the Flutter outline. So this is a simple trick if you are not able to view the Flutter outline. So now I am tapping on this particular widget text button, and I am extracting the widget here, and for which I will be writing a name for the widget like menu widget, and let's refactor it. Now we have got a class for menu widget. It's a stateless widget now, and here you can see we have provided the text widget inside. Let's remove this particular constructor and add own constructor parameters. I want to have a string title. It's asking for us to initialize, so let us do the same by declaring the default constructor this dot title here, and now our variable is now initialized, and instead of home here let us try to provide the title, and also the remaining fields are same. I just want the same font size, color and font weight for the all the other remaining options here. So now let us make use of this menu widget here. And now so one more thing I want to make is like this particular title is a compulsory requirement, so I am marking it as required. It will be showing a warning message for us if you have not specified that particular title. I want to specify it as home, and also all the remaining widgets I will be specifying it. It's so simple, right? Instead of writing the code every time for the same functionality. So making use of these classes, you can use them throughout your application with the same specifications, or you can just alter them by providing the required properties, as we have provided a property title here. So in the same way you can also alter the font weights, font size, everything. So now let us try to rerun the code and observe the changes. So here you can see all the menu options have been updated successfully. Let us try to add a slider in the center of the screen. So here we have a static image. This is a particular image we are trying to load. So I will be just removing this, and instead of this, now let us try to add a plugin to have a slider in our project. Carousel slider. Make sure there is no any indentation problem here. Let us make use of this particular slider in our project. So now let us have a look on this particular plugin here. So this is the carousel slider. Here you can see the examples of the different sliders available, and from which I will be choosing the full screen image slider, because I just want to make the height of the slider according to my website requirement. So now let us try to add the code for the same. Here in the example you are having the codes for the different sliders available. So now let us make use of them in our code and see how it works. So these are all the list of images which we are trying to populate in our image slider here. We are getting these images from the unsplash.com. I will be providing the code in the description section below, so you need not worry about the code. Just concentrate on this particular tutorial now. So here is our full screen slider, which is extending a stateless widget. So we are not performing any actions in this particular widget, so we are extending it with a stateless now. And here you can see it will be getting adjusted. For example, we are providing a container in our code and we have specified some height for it, so it will get adjusted to that particular height. And these are all the remaining options here. Viewport fraction we have provided 2.0, and enlarge center page as we have specified false for now, and autoplay also we have specified true, because I wanted the images to be loaded automatically. And if you don't want it, you can just specify false here. And these are all the list of images which we are mapping to our slider. You can see with the help of the image network. So previously also we have used the image network to load a single image on our web page. So here we are also making use of the image network, but here we are using a different scenario. Inside the carousel slider we are making use of it, and here you can see I have specified a width to be 1000 here. So this is our menu here, and now let us try to collapse this, and this is our footer. So now here we will be specifying one more container, and inside this container let us specify the child, and for which we will be specifying our full screen slider demo, and also I will be providing the height for it like 400, and let's try to see how this will get adjusted on our web page. So yes, our slider is now loaded successfully. So instead of these images links from the Unsplash, you can specify your own images, and also you can specify the images from the local folder. So inside the assets folder you can specify the images, and inside this list you can specify their path, and here instead of image network you can just specify image.assets. So if you are having any query how to load an image from the local assets, I will be providing a tutorial link in the description section below. Now let us try to separate this code menu widget. Let us try to remove this particular code and move to a separate file here. So we can make a separate package called components, and here inside which we can specify a dart file menu underscore button, and inside which we can specify this particular button coding. We need to import the material.dart package and also Google Fonts package. We need to just import our menu widget so that it gets recognized, and also let us try to move the list of images to a particular package. We can call it as repository for now, and here we can create a dart file repo, and here you can make sure you add the list of the things which you will be using in your application. And now we can also separate the Flutter's slider. Inside the components itself you can specify this like image slider, and here you can specify this, and also the same way you can import the material.dart file and also the carousel slider, and here you can also get the image list. So these are all the three imports required, and now here you can see our code looks better now. Also import this particular full screen slider. We have made the menu options much simpler now, and also this is our full screen slider demo. We are trying to limit the height of the slider, and also this is our footer. So here you can observe this is our footer view, and now you can also specify blue color itself, and also for our text field let us provide the color dot white, and now see the output once. It looks somewhat good, but also we need some height for it, so I want to specify 50, and also I want my footer to be in the center, so make it center now, and this will make, so yes, it's now in the center of the screen. And yes, now let us also try to make some changes in the header part as well. Inside the container we will try to make the background color to be blue, and also inside the button change the color to be white. Also add a height of 50. We have added our header part as well. So this is our header and this is our footer. Just try to wrap this inside a row, and after the image add a text widget. So here we will be specifying the name of website, and using the style tag let's provide the Google font. So I'm providing the particular font and also font size to be 20 and font weight bold and color to be blue as we have specified for every text widget. Let's wrap it inside a container and try to add some margin. I'm adding only onto the right side, so let's add 40 to be the margin and try to run the code and see. So here we are having our website name and logo to the left hand side, and to the right hand side we are having the menu options, and in the center we are having an image slider, and to the bottom we are having a footer. So in the coming tutorials we will see how to add the pages to our website and also how to route them from our current home page, and also we will be trying to add the details inside the about, profile, contact and help page, and thereafter we can finalize our website. This is it for this tutorial, and if you are having any queries in the implementation, do let me know in the comment section below. I will be providing the code for this tutorial in the description section below. In continuation to our previous tutorial, in this tutorial we will be adding different screens to our current existing web page here. So in our previous tutorials we have built a basic template in Flutter, and in our second tutorial we have added a slider to our home page and also customized the menu options and also the logo. So now we will try to add the functionality for these pages now. So create a package here called screens, and inside which we will be creating an about screen. So inside the about screen, import the material.dart package and create a stateless widget about. So here instead of container we will be returning a column inside which provide the children, and we will be having one text widget for now. So we will be providing the name to be about, and here also we will provide the styling for our text field here. So font size I will be providing 20 and font weight W700. So this is it, a basic about class, and you can add some more widgets below this text widget and provide your content. So we will be making use of this about class here and try to route to that particular screen. So one more thing I want to explain you here, this is our single child scroll view inside which our entire website is there. So it's still not a website, it's a web page currently. So our complete web page is there inside this single child scroll view, and if you go inside here you can see this is our column here, and inside the column this container is our header section, and the second container is our body section, and the third container is a footer section here. So these are the three sections we are having in our website, out of which the header and the footer we are keeping constant for this site currently, and just we are going to alter the body section here. So this is the second container we are going to alter. So if you see inside the second container we are having a single child, that is full screen slider demo, which is nothing but the image slider which is present inside the body here. So now we will try to replace this full screen slider demo with our about class and all the different classes like profile, contact, help. So now to do so, we need to have the onPress functionality inside to our buttons here. So these are the home, about, profile, contact and help buttons which you can see here. So we are currently not having onPress functionality for this button. So let's go ahead and add the onPress functionality now. So for which we need to declare a function, and this function we can call it as onPress so that we can easily understand it. So inside the onPress functionality we can just provide this for now, and also provide the same in our constructor. So yes, we are now enabled for onPress functionality, and here you can get the same. So we now got the onPress functionality, and just we are leaving blank for now. And as we discussed, we are having a single child, that is Flutter screen slider demo. I want to replace it with a widget screen. So here we will be creating a widget by name screen, and we will be providing the initial value to be Flutter screen slider demo. So we have made no change here, we are just declared it to this particular widget and we are making use of it now. So there will be no change in the output. In a simple way I want to deal this mechanism. We will be trying to store the screen equal to. So as we are dealing with the home page, we can just provide the full screen demo. We can provide the same class which we have provided as the initial value, full screen slider demo, for our home tag here. And inside the about here we will be having a change now. So for the screen here we are going to specify the about class, as we have just created the about class, import it. So yes, now we are having home and about. So still we are having profile, contact and help classes. We need to be creating them and we need to provide them in the same scenario right now. So now when you run this particular code and try to see the output, you will not be able to move to the about screen. And again, it's a basic, we have not specified the set state here. So for which we need to add the set state functionality also. So here you can see we have got home, about and profile, contact, help are still in disabled state. And when you tap on about, the functionality will be working in background, but you can't able to see because we have not provided the set state. So now let us provide this set state functionality and wrap it inside it, and now provide the same here also and wrap the screen inside it. And now try to save your program, and now you will be able to tap on the about. So you got the about screen here, and when you come back on home button you can get the slider back again. So this is a default way I am providing, and again there will be different mechanisms to provide this routing system. You can provide the initial routes and you can provide a set of routes for these particular classes here, but I want to make it as simple as possible for you to understand. And also I want to have the header and the footer section constant, and only the middle body section needs to be altered. We have tried about class for now, and still there are profile, contact and help. So I will give you a chance to try them, and like the same way how we have created an about class inside the screens, you may create the profile and contact and all these classes, and in the same way try to provide this functionality, and if you are getting any errors, you can come back and watch the video. So yes, in the same way we will be creating a profile and contact and also help. And to make it much faster, I will be copying the same code here, but try to replace the names, or else every screen will be same. So contact, and here also contact, and we are left with help screen. So help, and yes, we are done now. So here, instead of making the set state every time, we can also create a method here. So cut it and load screen, and inside which we can pass the widget here. So we can make use of the load screen functionality here, load screen and full screen demo. Yes, so in the same way you can do it for all the remaining classes as well. And now also make sure you change it here, provide the screen, or yes, you can make it like change screen and just provide it, and just provide it here to avoid the confusion. And now try to run the code and see the output. So here we got the screens now, and you can see all the buttons are now enabled. And I tap on the profile, so we got the profile screen, contact screen, help screen, about, and again we are back to the home screen here. And you can observe the footer and the header is the same now, only the body part is being currently varying. So here, this is it for this tutorial now, and in the coming tutorials we will be seeing more customizations in this particular website. So if you are having any queries, and if you want to add some more functionalities to this existing website, you may let me know in the comment section below. And as I want to make the series much easier for you to understand, I am just taking a single concept for every tutorial and in a very short duration. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. So in this blog, we will try to refactor the code. So once see the output, this is the output for our website. Here we have added screens in our previous tutorial. So I am providing the links for the previous tutorials on website creation. If you are viewing this tutorial for the first time, you may go through the tutorials to get a more idea of what we are dealing in this particular tutorial now. So here, if you see the number of lines we are having in the main.dart is 135 lines we are having here. So already we have created a menu widget here. So this is a coding for that button which we have used in our menu. But I want to still reduce the number of lines in the main.dart file, so for which I'm going to create a new .dart file and name it menu_items. So you can just provide whatever the name which is much easily recognizable for you. So here I'm going to create a stateless class, and I'm going to name it like menu items. So now here, So here we need to import material.dart file here. So now let us try to separate the menu items from our code. So here I'm going to collapse the flexible widget and now try to remove it from there and add it in here inside the return. So here we will be surely getting some errors like menu widget, it's not recognizable. So now let us try to import the menu widget. And also here you can see the main issue is with the load screen functionality. Why? Because this load screen functionality has set state here. So our main.dart is a stateful widget. So here we can refresh the state. But now we are considering a menu items class which is a stateless widget. So now let us try to handle the set state functionality from this particular class here. So any idea how to deal this particular task? You can pause this video here and you can try it, and if you are not getting it, just come back it, we will try to solve the issue. So here let us try to create a function with the same name we will be creating, like load screen, and now with the help of a constructor we will be initializing it. So this dot load screen, so yes, we have initialized it. And now here you can see these are all the class files for the particular screens. So let us get into the main.dart and remove all this from here and add these imports in our menu items.dart. So here you can see all the issues are gone, and now we need to import this particular image slider, and yes, you can remove it, unutilize the import. And now here our code is now easily readable. So let's try to add this menu items instead of the flexible here. So we have removed our flexible widget here. So here let us try to add the menu items, and here you can see it's imported. And here you can see we can access our menu items class which is of a stateless widget. But don't forget to pass the function here. So here we are having a function load screen as a parameter, so for which we need to pass load screen which we have defined here. So now let us try to run this code and see the output, and here we have got some error which is nothing but we need to remove this comma here. And now try to run this code and see the output. So here our application is restarted and now we are not having any errors. Try to tap on the buttons and here you can see we are now able to get the functionality like previously we did. So here you can see our 135 lines of code is now reduced to 92, and still we can reduce the code here. So this is the, so here you can see this particular block of code we are dealing with a gesture detector. And now I just want to remove this as well. So here extract widget, and here you can just rename it like gesture widget, or just simply I want to make it like logo widget, which is easily recognizable for me. So now here you can see our class is being created here. So now let us remove this from here and inside the components create a file logo underscore widget. So you might wonder why I am separating this. So here let us try to import Google Fonts as well. So you might wonder why I have separated this one, because here you can see this particular logo and on tap functionality, I can use it in any screen when we get into a real-time website. So there we need to again write the same code multiple times. So I want to separate this as a single component, and I can just import it wherever I require. And also in future you can just add parameters over here. So for now I don't have any parameter, just I want to display the logo with this particular specified width and the text. So in later on you can just customize them, you can provide them dynamically, as we have provided load screen here using the parameters. So now our code is further reduced by roughly 20 lines. So now this is the footer section. The same way we will extract the widget. So for this particular section I suggest you to do this, and if you are facing any trouble, get back to the video and you can see the solution. So here in the same way, go to the Flutter outline, and if the Flutter outline is empty for you, just tap on the widget by clicking on the command button, tap on the widget, and here you can see your Flutter outline is now loaded. So here on the container, tap on the extract widget, and here I am renaming it to be a footer widget and refactor it. So close the Flutter outline, and in the same way cut this part here, and inside the components create a dart file footer, and here you can just add it and import material.dart, and here you are now good to go just by importing it. So here now we have got 64 lines of code, and it's not just the lines of code, but here you can see how easily you can read this particular code now. So isn't it so simple? It's a better practice, like by refactoring the code you can make it much simple and easier. Even if you come back to this particular code after a week or after a month of time, then it will be easier for you to go line by line. Now we have separated the modules here, just we have created a single line in place of them, and when you tap on this particular widget you can just go into that and you can see what we are doing there. And here you can add more menu items also, and also you can just add some more lines of code here. So inside the about, just we have added a heading, and now you can just add one more text field here, and here you can provide some text like welcome to. Try to refresh the screen here. So inside the about section we have got some text, and using size box here you can provide some height like 20, and here I just want to provide the same styling which I have provided for about, and here just reduce the font size to 16 and this particular one to W300 and run the code. And here you can see we just got the about section. So in the same way you can just add the data for the remaining screens like profile, help and contact. So this is it for this tutorial on website creation, and in further coming tutorials we will be starting with a new topic, try to finish some demo projects on them. So I have provided the code for this entire series in the description section below, and also for more interesting Flutter tutorials visit our channel. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.